A very safe and good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd March, on the front page you have 80 districts in lockdown to contain virus spread. So with first deaths now reported in Bihar and Gujarat as well, toll has increased to 7 death toll in the country, and interstate transport, suburban trains, bus services have been suspended. So you can see here too, in Delhi, government of Kejriwal has announced curbs in the capital till March 31. So extraordinary measures, he says, are required to tackle this epidemic. And public transport has been suspended, especially except essential services. All other services have been suspended. International flights, national, domestic international flights to and from Delhi have been suspended. Public transport will function, and that too at 25% capacity, the DTC buses. Then this is regarding Janta curfew. PM thanks people for staying indoors, but battle not over. And this is an encounter which has happened in Chhattisgarh, in Bastar, in Sukma region. So, Maoists have been killed here. And this is important. This is IIT Delhi team develops cheaper COVID-19 test. So this is probe-free detection assay, and it has been sent to National Institute of Virology, Pune. So you can see it's an affordable test here, which has been developed. And the results are also claimed to be accurate. On the editorial page, the first editorial is stealing a mandate. So this is regarding Madhya Pradesh. BJP played the book, but a new government will lack moral legitimacy without winning by polls, is what this editorial says. Members from Congress resigning and the strength of the house reducing, BJP has formed the government in Madhya Pradesh. And below you have China zero. So this says the rest of the world might have to follow China's lead in containing the virus. So China has had zero cases of novel coronavirus from March 18 to 20, including in Wuhan, which was the epicenter of the epidemic. So this comes 3 months after the first case emerged in Wuhan. So China should lead, and nations should follow China's example in containing coronavirus. It had gone for a complete lockdown, and that seems to have paid off. And the lead article is the perils of an all-out lockdown. So this article talks of how if the poor must stay at home, they need income support and essential services. So daily wage earners are the most affected in such a scenario, and government needs to step in to help them tap social schemes as such. And this is picking up the quantum technology baton. So it says with the budget announcement providing direction, stakeholders need to roll out national mission quickly. So this is regarding quantum computing. You can see. Over the next 5 years, the budget has proposed spending 8,000 crores on national mission on quantum technologies and applications. So the quantum revolution is an important topic which needs to be covered. See, besides computing, it is said exploring the quantum world promises other dramatic applications, including creation of novel materials, enhanced metrology, secure communication, to name just a few. On opposite page, you have how to handle a pandemic. So this is regarding how Kerala government has been successful in putting public health sector back on the rails to tackle coronavirus. On page 10, you have seizure of Afghan meth on high seas triggers concern. So this meth, which is known as shisha, glass, in Afghanistan, is actually a drug. So it's a psychostimulant, and it's a psychostimulant party drug. So this contraband is being smuggled. So Sri Lanka Navy actually seized two such trawlers as such, which were smuggling this contraband. So it indicates there is a well-established heroin trafficking route here. And this is Trinamool NCP Sena to skip parliament. So keeping houses open was not an example to set, is what is being stated by these opposition parties, and they say they will not attend parliament when it reconvenes on Monday. The budget session is going on presently. Then on page 11, you have ICMR saying isolation is India's best weapon to break down virus transmission. And in Maharashtra too, section 144 has been invoked. So there it is to ensure that there is no overcrowding. So it will be imposed in all cities of Maharashtra to fight coronavirus. So the number of government employees working in offices will be also be cut down to just 5% from existing 25%. On international page you have, amid lockdown, viruses cases cross 3 lakh. So more than half the cases are now in Europe, with Italy, France and Spain shut to the outside world. And in Italy also, the coronavirus spread, it is said, because action to isolate areas, limit movements, need to be taken early. And here you have, COVID-19 hit Zagreb, which is the capital of Croatia in Europe, suffers quake jolt. It is 5.3 magnitude earthquake, which is the biggest to hit the region. So, amid coronavirus outbreak, now an earthquake has also struck here. And this is, can China's model work for the West? So China's top-down COVID-19 approach, it is said, may be hard to replicate elsewhere. So the head of World Health Organization believes China's battle offers a beacon of hope, but others question China's strategy, whether it can be followed in other countries, especially in Western democracies. So here you can see the top-down, centrally controlled one-party authoritarian state that allowed no dissent and can mobilize vast resources on a single issue was able to contain the virus, but this is not possible in democracies in Europe. Then below you have Guinea referendum to extend Condé's rule. So this is African nation, Guinea, where a referendum was held despite COVID-19 threat. Opposition also boycotted the constitutional referendum, but this referendum went ahead, and this referendum, which opposition fears may give President Alpha Conde another 12 years to govern. And then on Mondays on business page you have money wise coverage, which is individual decision, you know, investment decisions. So this you can easily skip. So that is it. Those were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. Thank you.